بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. السلام علیکم. ویلکم ٹو ایپس ایکس آن لائن سپورٹ پروگرام. دس پروگرام انیبلز یو ٹو لرن ایٹ ہوم. ہوپ یو آل آر ڈوئنگ ویل. آئی ایم مبین مشتاق اینڈ آئی ول ٹیچ یو کیمسٹری. وی آر ڈسکسنگ اباؤٹ چیپٹر نمبر 5, دیٹ از فزیکل اسٹیٹس آف میٹر. وی ہیو ڈسکسڈ اباؤٹ دا گیشیئس اسٹیٹ اینڈ ناؤ وی آر گوئنگ ٹو ڈسکس اباؤٹ لیٹسٹ نالج. You should know the answer of these questions. What do you know about liquid state? Liquid is also a physical state of matter like the gaseous state, but it has some properties different from the gaseous state. And what happens when we boil water? You all know what happens when we boil water. When we boil water, water converts into the vapor form. Now coming to the topic, that is the liquid state of matter, we will discuss some of the typical properties of liquid. First of all, we will discuss about evaporation. First, we will define evaporation, conversion of a liquid to a gas or vapor at all temperature is called vaporization or evaporation. Evaporation continues at all temperature. Even if the temperature is less than the boiling point of the liquid, we can say that evaporation does not require boiling of a liquid. Evaporation continues at all temperatures and it is the conversion of liquid to a gas or vapors at all temperatures, even when the temperature is less than the boiling point of that liquid.
Okay.
Now come to the explanation of evaporation. In evaporation, some of the molecules in the liquid break away and enter the gas or vapor state. When any liquid converts into the vapor phase, this is known as evaporation. And which molecules are turning into the vapor state? The molecules which have higher kinetic energy than average kinetic energy can break away and enter the gas or vapor state. Only those molecules which have greater kinetic energy, they can escape from the surface of the liquid in the form of vapors. This means that molecules with the highest kinetic energy will escape first. You can see in the figure some of the molecules in the red color. You can see these molecules. These molecules are escaping from the surface of the liquid and these are the molecules which have highest kinetic energy. They will escape first. Now, there is a question, is evaporation is a cooling process? Yes, evaporation is a cooling process. It causes cooling because the process requires heat energy. We have mentioned in the definition of evaporation that it is a process of conversion of liquid into vapors at all temperatures, even at the temperature less than the boiling point of the liquid. It does not require boiling, but somehow some temperature is involved in the process of evaporation and temperature has an influence on the evaporation. As we increase temperature, the process of evaporation increases. That's why this process requires some heat energy. The energy is taken away by the molecules when they convert from liquid into the gas. And this causes cooling on the original surface. This can be explained by this figure. You can see in the figure that there are three types of molecules you can see in the figure. These are any molecules of any liquid. You can see some molecules are slow molecules which are settled down. Some molecules are moving randomly and some molecules are escaping from the surface of the liquid. The molecules which are escaping from the surface of the liquid are those molecules which have highest kinetic energy. Fast molecules, they have high kinetic energy, they are near the surface and they may escape from the surface of the liquid. Slow molecules which have low kinetic energy, they left behind. Average kinetic energy of the remaining molecule decreases because the molecules with the highest kinetic energy are leaving the surface of the molecules. The molecules left behind are those molecules which have low kinetic energy. As a result, temperature of the liquid decreases. Why it is decreases? Because the molecules that are moving from the surface to the outside in the form of vapors, they are dragging the temperature of that liquid. That's why temperature of the liquid decreases, and when temperature of the liquid decreases, it causes a cooling effect. This is all about evaporation. This is the summary of evaporation. You can clearly see this in this figure. Now coming to the assignment, that is for you students, you should know the reasons and answers of these questions. First of all, give reason. When you put nail polish remover on your palm, you feel a sensation of coldness. Give reason for this. Second one, wet cloths dry quickly in summer, then in winter. Why? What is the reason behind this? And learn all about evaporation. This is all about today's lecture. Stay home, stay safe.